everyone at this graduation today has the ability to change the world. Don't say, I'm not smart enough, I don't know, have enough money, etc., etc. There have been many young people who have changed the world. One of the first people who come to my mind is Lila Rose, who single-handedly exposed the deceptive practices and predatory behavior of minorities of Planned Parenthood, bringing forth great reductions in their federal funding. But I also think about a 15-year-old boy, Louis Braille, who created a form of reading for blind children. When he was 3 years old, an eye injury had left him blind. Despite his blindness, he succeeded in his education and got a prestigious scholarship to join the Royal Institute of the Blind Youth. He started a system that would help blind people to read and write quickly, which he presented to his peers at the age of 15. Anne Frank wrote The Diary of a Young Girl, one of the world's most widely known books. Her family went into hiding for 2 years when the persecution of the Jewish population increased, but they were eventually arrested by the Gestapo and sent to a concentration camp. She died at the age of 15 in a camp just a couple months before the end of the war. Her diary was published in 1952 by her father and translated into over 60 languages. She wanted to be a journalist, but didn't survive to witness her diary being praised for its literary merits. Jack Andreka was a boy who was born in 1997, and as a point of reference from when Men in Black came out. He was an ordinary kid until a close family friend died of pancreatic cancer. This inspired Jack to look for a way to identify early stages of cancer. At the age of 15, he invented a new type of sensor to spot the presence of cancer cells, which proved to be less expensive, much faster, times 168, and more accurate, 25 to 50%, than all other tests. As the old story goes, he was rejected by almost 200 labs until he was finally endorsed and used at Johns Hopkins Medical Center. Think of the power of St. John the Apostle. Tradition tells us that not only was he Jesus' most beloved apostle, but also the teenage apostle. Endowed with an education far less than yours, but filled with the Holy Spirit, he wrote words that have inspired us to follow the ways of Christianity for 2,000 years. And so, Grace, Victoria, and Nora, each of you have the ability, armed with your education and your Christian faith, to leave your mark on the world, all for the better. Grandfathers, mothers and fathers, sisters and brothers, cousins and friends, please let me present to you the class of 2020. Seven up is your
welcome today. And judges should be along shortly, and we have some food catered in from Longitude 315 in Highwood. It's a South American fair. And, oh yeah, Miss Bridget has just told me, Mrs. Bridget Lee just told me that we have a keg of root beer over here. So, hey, Peggy, where did that come from?
Benny's.
And if you want ice cream in there, we have a black house also. So the food should be along pretty soon. Please milk yourself at home and feel free to give your own advice to our new graduates.
And for the hostess with the most.